The moment we've all been waiting for. It's time to race. Can you believe it? Pecco crashes out. Well, here comes Fabio Quartararo. He's the winner. Fabio Quartararo conquers the Catalan Grand Prix. Surely that is game over for Pecco Bagnaia. He's going to be nearly 100 points potentially behind Fabio Quartararo.
Quartararo now attacks.
Oh, he's down! Oh no, Fabio Quartararo's gone down! And Dash TT winner is Pecco Bagnaia. Pecco Bagnaia, the first Ducati rider in history to win four races on the spin.
Grazie a tutti.
2 points now splitting Fabio Quartararo and Pecco Bagnaia. The greatest comeback in the 73-year history of Grand Prix race. Game on, it's the title decider. Pecco Bagnaia will be crowned 2022 MotoGP World Champion.
Last year I became MotoGP World Champion and my life dream was completed because I won what I wanted to win. I had to change my dream now, so it was something strange to understand, but now my dream is to continue for many years winning titles. I would like to be one of the greatest of the history.
¿Te gusta el trofeo ahí tan cerca?
¿Lo has robado en mi casa o qué? Since I remember, just Mark and Vale have repeated the title. And the level of this year is even higher than last year. The bike of each rider are so competitive, so it will be tough.
Thank you.
MotoGP in 2023, for me, is without any question the strongest grid we've had in history. Four MotoGP World Champions, 13 MotoGP Grand Prix winners, and a whole bunch of fast and hungry young riders that want to take the big prize. These are the 22 fastest and best riders on the planet. And we come to Portimao, everybody wants to start the season strongly. Pecco Bagnaia, the reigning world champion, he's the clear pre-season favorite, and he knows who the big rivals are going to be.
Fabio Quartararo, because he's one of the strongest riders, I think, ever in the MotoGP history.
World champion, baby!
¿Estás listo o no?
Siempre. Siempre listo.
Digo para la entrevista, ¿eh?
Hay que ser listo para todo.
Ahora hacemos un vlog. Cada fin de semana os voy en el blanco. ¿Vale?
Sí,
¿cómo estáis? ¿Hola qué?
He and Yamaha are going to respond. I mean, you have to remember, Fabio, halfway through last year, looked absolutely nailed on to retain the championship, 91 points clear. So he'll be really hurting and really motivated to win that championship back from Pecco.
I think one of the first time that I have this anger in myself. I'm here to fight, and this year I want to focus with what I have. And even if I'm struggling a little bit in the beginning, I want to give my best. I know that every point is important, so it's clear what I want. And is the world title, not just only for this year, but for the next 10. Mar Marquez, for his story, for his angriness of win, the revenge he want to demonstrate, and for his talent, for sure.
Bueno, esa mejor no mirarla mucho. Fíjate, ¿no?
Sí, tienes
mucha. Sí, ahí en casa las veo cada día, cada 6. 1, 2, 3.
Is he back to his best? Is Honda back to its best? Is he going to finally match Valentino Rossi, you know, and win that ninth world championship? That's one of the big questions.
Of course, it's my dream, and of course, it's my ambition. After 3 years in a row with a lot of pain, injuries, I mean, thinking was hard, but then everything arrived in a normal way. And I worked this winter on the gym every day because I want to be champion, not because I want to finish race, no. I like the pressure, and I'm putting pressure to myself, and I want to fight for the top positions. But you need to be honest to your situation. Honda is coming from a very difficult period these 3 years. For that reason, I don't know what I'm doing here as a top contender. And I don't understand why I was on the main press conference with the two top contenders.
We welcome the reigning world champion, Pekka Bagnaia, Fabio Quartararo, runner-up last season, and completing today's lineup is Repsol Honda's Marc Márquez.
Ya me tiras de la lengua. Hombre, hay uno que quedó detrás mío en el campeonato. O sea, yo tampoco puedo luchar mucho.
Aleix Espargaró, because him last year demonstrated with consistency, and also him and Grinesov demonstrated that he's one of the fastest was there.
Qué bonito. Da mala suerte tocarlo, ¿no dicen? No lo toco. Més mala sort que vaig tenir l'any passat al final. Ferruccio Piguet li faig un morreo l'any passat. Sembla que siem a Miami.
Aleix Espargaró was the big surprise package, wasn't he, of 2022? And you feel that another year's experience with him on the RSGP, Aleix is going to be fighting for the championship.
I'm really motivated. I'm in a really good moment of my career, of my life, with my family, with my team, with the most competitive bike I ever had. We improved quite a lot the level of the Aprilia.
Salute, ragazzi!
The key will be, again, to maintain a good level during all races without making any mistakes. We did enough things to be membership of this club.
Enea Bastianini, because he's my teammate. We have we had many battles last year in the last part of the season, and he for sure want to demonstrate that he's one of the strongest.
De comentar igual champion, seguimos a los contenders y tú harás contender, ¿no?
Ah, okay, sí, sí.
¿Te piace? Es el contender.
Me piacerebbe, sí.
He really did raise his level, 4 wins last year, and I think he's going to be a big, big rival in that Ducati team with Pecco this year, no question.
3, 2, 1, ancora una.
I work a lot during this winter to arrive prepared for this, and really motivated to fight for this goal.
Vorrei mettere un qualcosa qui. Qui sta bene, no?
Diciendo que tenemos que poner su nombre ya al lado, aquí.
Sí,
¿eh? Falta Enea
Bastianini. Sí, sí. Es justo ser ambiciosos.
Well, that's what all the riders have to be, ¿no?
We are here for them.
Since Pecco crossed the line in Valencia to win the World Championship, the big debate was, will he run the number one place? Was he going to stay with 63, or was he going to be the first rider since Casey Stoner in 2012 to run the number one plate?
Number one signifies he is the best in the world. Only the best one, the legend, display the number one.
Pecco. Francesco Bagnaia.
he's the number one at the moment, no?
Everybody knows he's the world champion, but now even more because he has the number one. To have one bike with the number one on the racetrack also is nice, and he will defend.
The importance and the significance for him on a personal level of running the number one plate, it was very special for him. You know, it's a badge of honor almost, you know, something that a rider works their whole life for.
He has the best bike at the moment. When you put the best bike plus the best rider, the faster rider, then it's quite very difficult to beat him.
He's the best rival, the most difficult to battle with him. Have a lot of experience with this bike.
He have the confidence of being world champion. He have the fastest bike, but he's the fastest at the moment.
Last year, he destroyed all of us. He was in another level. His speed was super high. And I think that him and Ducati learned the mistake they did at the beginning of 22 season, and he will start strong. So he's the man to beat without any doubt.
As a statement to the other riders, I'm the number one, guys. You know, you're gonna have to work really hard to take this number one plate from me.
Solo puede quedar uno 2023.
There you go then, ladies and gentlemen. That is your class of 2023 assembled and ready. MotoGP in 2023, a complete new era. Massive change for the championship. Probably one of the biggest changes we've had in the 74-year history of Grand Prix racing. The most exciting of those changes coming on Saturday afternoons with the new Tissot Sprint. Half race distance, the guys can go out there, they don't have to worry about fuel management, they don't have to worry about time management, it's just full throttle. Now, qualifying has so much extra importance. Your starting position on that grid counts for the Tissot Sprint on Saturday and for the main Grand Prix on Sunday. This is a game changer. This is a huge 15 minutes which can determine whether your weekend is good, bad or ugly. Bagnaia at the moment on course for P1, and the number one does indeed go into P1. P1 is not safe in his pocket. Here we go then. Marquez has latched onto the back of number 23, Enea Bastianini. Enea Bastianini might be inadvertently helping Marc Marquez here take pole position away from Bastianini's teammate. Over the line, Marc Marquez will come. Is it pole? It is! Incredible! Bastianini is inadvertently helping one of their big rivals, one of Pekka Bagnaia's main rivals for the championship, to pole position, giving him a bit of a upper hand. But why did Enea do it? Because it was to the detriment of Ducati. But I think in some situations, you don't really have a choice as well, because you're out there pushing for yourself.
He's just doing his own thing. Sometimes when you follow a rider, sure, it's up to luck and hoping they don't look behind and close the throttle. But a more skilled way to choose your victim is to look for somebody who you know is fast, but they need to do the lap. They won't roll out of it, and Mark's good at that.
Mark is back in the game, and that spells trouble for his rivals, because if Mark's back in the game, then, you know, those guys are going to have a very difficult 2023.
Per me ci saranno almeno 4 penalità.
Sì?
Aleix, Mark, Bestia e Oliveira.
Okay.
Io stavo spingendo la traiettoria.
Come sempre.
Vostra moto corre más hoy.
Hoy.
No sé.
Hoy corre más.
Hoy corre más, no me calláis.
El viento.
No, el viento no. Yo cuando iba así ayer y pío menos, ¿eh? La gasolina, tío.
Es que
las motocitas, ¿no?
Tu hermano. Yo estaba con mi hermano.
Enea is his own man, does what he wants to do, says what he wants to say. Some of the Italians say he's a bit crazy, but I'd ask you to name a top rider that isn't a mix of crazy and intelligent, you know, which Enea is.
is not scared before the season to sort of, all the Italian riders are kind of favouring their own. They're saying, well, Pecco Bagnaia is going to win the world championship. And then Bastianini is going, well, I think Marc Marquez is going to be the favourite, which, you know, so he's not afraid to express his own personal opinion.
This is what we have been waiting for. We've been looking forward to 2023 and the start of a golden new era in the MotoGP World Championship.
The new schedule, it certainly does ramp up the stress. Q2 on Saturday morning, there's only 2 or 3 hours before you've got to be ready to go into that Tissot sprint scenario.
The tension has been building up to this first ever sprint race. You can feel the atmosphere on the grid, and you know what they're going to do. They're going to take more risk.
It's full throttle, lights out, and the MotoGP sprint era is go here in Portimao. Good start from the third place on the grid by Jorge Martin. Marc Marquez has got away well too. Here comes Andrea Bastianini, who's fired up from sixth place. He's second behind Marquez.
Van a follar en la recta.
No, llega fuerte, fuerte. No llega. Espera.
Lo verás.
Mia on the inside of Quartararo. Nail-biting action. The two Aprilias almost touched Jack Miller's KTM. Here comes Marc Marquez, two for the price of one. 4.5 kilometres left here in the Algarve International Circuit, the last lap of a Tissot sprint blockbuster. Martin was wide, a fraction offline in turn five.
Die.
He's absolutely fast. Marquez was going through, and Oliveira was off the circuit. The world champion, the number one, is number one in the first ever Tissot sprint race. Marc Marquez, after a heroic ride from pole position, Marquez takes third place.
Ne devi fare solo 42, altre 41 così e poi siamo
andati, ed è fatta. Bel lavoro.
We keep working together.
Oh, yeah.
We will do.
Esta no,
vamos por delante.
Venían, he hecho un poco se lo he dicho a él, porque en la recta, sí, pero he hecho, bueno, luego hablamos.
Siamo terzi al mondiale.
Terzi, adesso siamo terzi.
Te puedo decir los que nos daban, pero es que no lo había calculado.
Pero vuelve a pasar lo del año pasado, el floating un poco había, pero la vuelta de que he salido.
Bueno, tranquilo, disfruta.
Abbiamo la stessa velocità dell'anno scorso. Ducati non è così tanto più avanti che noi. Così, tutto il qualifying. I nostri sforzi vanno al qualifying. No, se llego a ser il grande gano. O segundo o tercero me tiran, pero estoy para ganar.
Los tiempos que
hacen. Hostia, Quartararo 6 segundos.
Certainly not the best start to the season for Fabio Quartararo, but it's a completely disastrous start for Andrea Bastianini. The worst possible start imaginable for Andrea. Who knows when he's going to be back, because a right shoulder blade injury is a serious injury.
Subito già?
Per essere a Austin.
Austin, che
è già difficile.
Thank you.
The greatest motorsport show on earth is back on the road after the new MotoGP sprint proved an instant hit. We're back for the main feature race at the Tissot Grand Prix of Portugal. You hear
the beat of the gun. And the race on Sunday is still wide open. Yeah, Pecco's gonna be there, but Mark really wants it. The KTMs have really closed the gap. The Aprilias are competitive, and it's Miguel Oliveira's home track. He's won there before.
Marc Marquez gets set to start from pole position for a record 64th time.
We're all set to go here in Portugal. Marc Marquez got away really well from pole position. Bagnaia gets squeezed by both Martin and Marquez. He had to back out of it there, didn't he? And coming through, fast starting, is Miguel Oliveira. Oliveira briefly at his home Grand Prix.
And then we've got an Aprilia around the outside of Maverick Viñales. He's off to a great start. He's trying to go wheel to wheel with Bagnaia and Oliveira. Up to
now. Oh, I thought it was a push off. Didn't he? What's contact? Marquez was super aggressive on the inside of Oliveira Martin into turn number three. Oliveira, though, is back at the front. The crowd are on their feet here in Portugal. You can barely hear yourself think because the Portuguese fans, they're already sensing maybe a historic victory here. Bagnaia's gone for it into the first gear, turn number 13. It was tight, but he made it move in there.
Marquez!
He has absolutely slammed into Miguel Oliveira.
Marquez returns to the pit box. You can hear some shouting from the fans there, of course. They're not happy with Marc Marquez.
The reaction from the crowd was shouting abuse. It was quite shocking to see, actually.
Marc Marquez, as we thought he would do, goes straight down to the pit box of Aprilia RNS Miguel Oliveira, and an apologetic sort of gesture as well to the crowd.
In the space of, what, 24 hours, Marc Marquez can go from hero to zero.
Pecco Bagnaia showing just why he's the reigning world champion. Bagnaia wins the Grand Prix of Portugal.
Si è infilato all'interno, ha toccato Martin che si è allargato e ha preso in pieno Oliveira che era davanti.
En la radiografía que le hemos hecho hay una posible fractura en el primer metacarpiano de la mano derecha.
After an amazing Saturday from Mark, Sunday was a disaster. Locking the front, anyone can do it. Taking everyone out, it should be punished.
Well, I did a big mistake, and yeah, I have been penalized for that mistake for the Argentina GP with a double long lap that I'm completely agree.
After all his good preparation to be ready to fight for the championship, he's injured again.
Some of the title contenders that we really thought were going to be prominent had a real tough weekend. I mean, Fabio Quartararo and Yamaha were very average. A qualified eighth, he was a long, long way off in the Grand Prix.
The way we are riding the bike, to fight with them right now is not possible.
Aleix Espargaró, P6,
who was super strong in 2022. We didn't really see him frigging at the front.
No he sido capaz de adelantar, tengo que mejorar ahí. Pero no había muchos huecos, los pilotos frenaban tarde, así que no tenía muchas ganas de chocar a nadie y al final no vino.
We're leaving Portimao, of the biggest names in the championship, in hospital. And now Bastianini, what was it, 5 laps into the sprint, he gets collected by Luc Marini and there's the broken right shoulder blade, so we won't see an Ayer for a good period of time as well. On Sunday night in Portimao, having won the sprint and the Grand Prix, maximum points, and we're all thinking, this is going to be easy. But nothing is easy in MotoGP. What we will see now is new names emerging as world championship contenders.
Ahora Rita, hemos vuelto.